Quoi de neuf tout le monde et bienvenue à une autre leçon débutante de français avec Gareth. Je m'appelle Gareth, l'américain qui va t'aider à parler un meilleur français. Aujourd'hui, nous allons apprendre à conjuguer le verbe avoir, un verbe très important dans la langue française. Donc tu vas tout apprendre aujourd'hui avec moi. Viens et on commence tout de suite. On y va. Salut,
ça va?
Salut, ouais, ça va.
Oh, qu'est-ce que tu as là?
Oh, j'ai beaucoup de choses en fait. J'ai une cravate, j'ai une écharpe de Toulouse, j'ai un chapeau de cowboy, j'ai un livre en portugais,
hein?
J'ai des baguettes chinoises, j'ai une cuillère, j'ai un ballon de rugby,
hein?
J'ai des chaussures, j'ai des skis,
hein?
J'ai un oreiller, j'ai un maillot, oh, ça appartient à toi, hein? J'ai un aspirateur,
hein?
Bon bah c'est tout cool, mais là je dois partir, donc il y a quelqu'un.
Hé, hey, qu'est-ce que vous avez là?
Oh, j'ai beaucoup de choses en fait. Donc voilà, aujourd'hui nous allons apprendre le verbe avoir. So the verb avoir is actually how you say to have en français. This is one of the most used and most versatile verbs in the entire French language, which is going to be great because you're going to learn how to use it today. And by the end of this video, you should be able to, without a problem, understand and speak in a conversation somewhat similar to the one at the beginning. So, the very first step of learning this is going to be learning how to conjugate it. After learning how to conjugate it, we're going to go over some expressions with the verb avoir. And then by the end, you should bring it all together and speak as if you were a fluent French man, like my friend François, the guy with the mustache and the beret. So, follow along and you're going to learn all this. Bringing us on to the conjugations, we've got our fancy little conjugation tree right here for avoir. That is what is referred to as the conjugation tree by people who learn other languages. Very first, you will notice that we've got lots of little words. Those are the subjects, the je, the tu, the il, the elle, all through the other side. All of those are the subjects en français, the personal pronouns, explaining if it's I that's doing something, or we that's doing something, or you, and whatever. Then, you will notice that all of the different forms of avoir are different depending on what subject they're with. Starting up at that top left corner, we've got j'ai. So j'ai is how you're gonna say I have. I have, just like that, is going to be just any other situation that you have en français when you say I have, like at the beginning of the video, where I was talking about all of the different things that I had in my backpack. I have is j'ai. Make sure that you're repeating along out loud with me to get down the pronunciation. The next one is tu as. Tu as is going to be our way of saying the informal version of you, you have. The informal, more casual. Hopefully you remember from the verse video where I showed you that French has the tu and the vous form to explain you, to talk about you doing something. Tu is our informal casual form. Tu as and j'ai, those are our first two conjugations. The next one down is il and elle. Il is he and elle is she. That's how you're going to say he has or she has. Il, elle, one of them, a. So, j'ai, tu as, and il or elle, a. Those are our first three conjugations of avoir. Moving on to the next one, we've got our nous. Nous is the pronoun en français. That means we. So, nous avons is how you're going to say we have. Nous avons. So, repeat out loud after every single one of these conjugations to get down that pronunciation. Nous avons is the next one. The bottom one next to that, or right under it, I guess, is not quite the very last one, is vous avez. Vous avez is our more formal way of saying you. However, it is also the plural form of saying you. So, if I want to talk in a formal situation to somebody, I would use vous with them. Or if I'm talking to a group of people and addressing them all at the same time, that is also vous. So vous avez is going to be how you say you have to either a formal situation with a person or to a group of people like y'all. So vous avez, excuse me, that's that conjugation right there. And the last one now is il, elle, plural. This conjugation is on, O-N-T, and it is pronounced altogether with the pronoun ils ont with a Z sound or elles ont. And that comes from what is called a liaison. A liaison en français is when you tie the last letter of a first word to the first letter of the next word. So it ties together and it makes all of the language flow together. It's usually going to happen when the last letter of that first word is a consonant and the first letter of the next word is a vowel. That's when you're going to tie things together. Il, one more special thing about it, is that il is going to be used when you have a group of all guys. Elle is going to be used when you have a group of all girls. And then you're going to go back to il if you have a group of guys and girls all together. So il and elle is, both of them mean they, but you got to use them depending on the situation. The next step in getting down the verb avoir is going to be talking about the expressions that we can use with the verb avoir. The very first one is nice and obvious. It's just saying you have something. So vous avez un livre. That is how you're going to say you have a book. Vous avez un livre. If you want to say other things, you can switch out all of the different pronouns. Say j'ai un livre, or tu as un livre, or ils ont un livre. Just switch out all of the conjugations and the pronouns, but that is how that verb is used in that situation. The next one is going to be using it in talking about having hunger or having thirst, which is how it's going to be translated. But if you want to speak normal English, it's like saying I'm hungry or I'm thirsty. The first one is going to be I'm hungry. That is j'ai faim. It's kind of like saying I have hunger en français. J'ai faim is our first one. That means I'm hungry. The second one is j'ai soif. J'ai soif is I am thirsty. It just means I have thirst, basically. So j'ai faim is I'm hungry. J'ai soif is I'm thirsty. Those are two more very important expressions that you're going to need to use with the verb avoir. The last expression that I want to show you for right now that uses avoir is going to be the expression of saying something about need. You need something. That's going to be this expression right here, avoir besoin de. Avoir besoin de, all three of those words have to be all together in order to actually mean to need. And you're going to conjugate that avoir to whatever subject it is that you're talking about needs something. So, j'ai besoin de is going to be I need, just like that. And then after the de, you can have whatever it is that you need. You can have another verb to say that you need to do something, or you can have a noun to say that you need that thing. So an example of that would be like, j'ai besoin de... dormir. J'ai besoin de dormir. That's going to be I need to sleep. And you just put another verb after that. And we're going to be running through lots of other verbs throughout the rest of this series. So stay tuned for that. J'ai besoin de dormir. Then the other situation where you can use it with a noun is going to be like j'ai besoin d'un livre. We're going to go back to our books, especially since school just got out and we're getting ready for the spring and summer terms, if you're into that. So j'ai besoin d'un livre is going to be I need a book. This right here, this d'un, the d apostrophe un, is what you're going to do to make a contraction when you have the two vowels together. But that is also something that we're going to come back to in the future. So j'ai besoin d'un livre is our whole phrase right there. That means I need a book. As you can probably see, avoir is a very versatile verb, and you can use it in tons of different situations. These are just a few situations that I wanted to let you know right now to have you start practicing how to use avoir. Make sure that before the next video comes out, that you've run through as many different situations as you can think of using all these different expressions I just gave you. That's talking about actually having something. That's talking about being hungry and thirsty. That one's pretty easy to practice. Then I really want you to make sure that you practice the needing part as well. Practice just saying that you need stuff and translate it as you're going throughout the day to keep on practicing. Come back to the next video and we're going to continue on with more expressions and more ways to use these verbs en français, bringing another one at you very soon. So thank you very much for watching. Make sure to go down into the comments and leave your questions there. Specifically, I want to know what topic you want to be able to talk about en français, and I will for sure do a video on it. So go down there, leave that little comment down there, and I will see you in the next one.